All right, man, so you guys have been asking for my jump shots forever. Literally, the game came out like a week ago, and all I'm hearing on Twitter is, Agent, where's some jump shot videos at? So yesterday, I dropped a video talking about some little Discord tech. If you're a shooter and you're trying to get better at shooting, I'll leave a link in the description. I dropped some dope tips there. In that video, I gave you guys some pointers and some jump shots I thought were dope. And in that video, I also told you guys that I'm gonna come out with some high latency jump shots for the people that incur more delay when they play. So let's break it down like this. The reason I talk about latency so much is because it affects jump shooting a lot. So let's bring up our handy dandy diagram of shot meter here. Let's say I'm trying to hit the green window to get my perfect release, right? While most people release the ball over here because they have low latency, I have to release the ball all the way over here because I have high latency. So if I'm using a low latency jump shot and I'm dealing with high latency, admittedly, my shot's gonna be off. It's not gonna reach the green window. The good thing about crafting the perfect jump shot is it helps you snap into the green window. So if you're snapping a little bit further away or a little bit too short because the latency changed, then you're messing up. So you wanna be prepared for any situation, right? For me, unfortunately, there's crowds around the park literally every time I play. So because I have to load all those players while I'm playing the game, there's higher latency. It's unfortunate, but it's the way I have to play. Agent, how do I know if I'm dealing with low or high latency? Well, first of all, if you've never experienced high, you probably would never know. But for most 2K players, I'd assume, you kind of go back and forth between the two. You know, one day the servers are off, it's double XP weekend, and you experience that delay that's high. That's usually what me and a lot of other people had to deal with. The easiest way to check it out is just click options, and then in the menu where you can mute people and look at your stats, just scroll around. It's the easiest way to check delay without going up for a jump shot. Last thing you wanna do is find out in the middle of your jump shot that you're dealing with high or low. All right, so again, low latency, base 49, Curry release 1, Curry release 2, best jump shot in the game. If you're dealing with high, ladies and gentlemen, I have a surprise for you. So let's head over to our handy dandy jump shot creator here. I've been spending a lot of time on this. If you've been watching the Facebook streams, like I've been crafting those jump shots, testing them out, in the process, taking some L's, because some of them end up being flops, of course. Here's the thing, when I'm playing on the park, people think that I'm always tryharding all the time. So people come on with jump shot boosts, with Gatorade boosts, all everything imaginable. And here I am testing a jump shot. And in the process, I'm not playing with tryhards, I'm just playing with friends. And then they'd be dropping me off, talking all this shit in the chat, like,
oh, how do you have 700,000?
I'm like, bro, I thought you was a fan a second ago. Literally, I could just stick with this jump shot and chill for the rest of the year, but I'm gonna end up experimenting more. You never know if there's better ones out there. So the jump shot I'm talking about is base 49. Release 1 is LaMarcus Aldridge, and release 2 is Kevin Durant. Base 49 is my favorite base in the game. I think it's the easiest one to cue. When I'm shooting, you guys know I don't look at my shot meter, I look at my player. So when I'm creating a jump shot, I give myself an easy cue so I can release the ball at the same time every single time, so I'm always shooting green. When I think about jump shots, I don't really think about it analytically, I think about it more emotionally. Does that make sense? That sounds like a really weird thing to say out loud. Okay, let me show you what I mean. Base 49, I told you guys in the last video, this is the motion I think of when I'm going up for my shot. Here I am standing, I go back and then forward, and then I hit the jump shot. It's like a sideways U. LaMarcus Aldridge, the motion usually is up, forward. He pushes the ball all the way up and then flicks his hands forward. And Kevin Durant is like a backwards flick, forwards flick. Kevin Durant is probably the easiest release in the game. Also, side note, if you're dealing low latency, ladies and gentlemen, Kevin Durant and Klay Thompson are fantastic jump shots this year. In previous years, they were average. I wouldn't use them. But this year in NBA 2K19, yo, you can literally just equip the regular Kevin Durant or the regular Klay Thompson and start shooting lights out. I think on the first day of launch, I was playing with Dirkster and Davis, and Dirkster was like, yo, Kevin Durant is a dope ass release. And I was like, just Kevin Durant, my guy? I don't believe you, because it wasn't dope in previous years. Then I tried it and he was spitting facts. It works in low latency in case you wanted an alternative jump shot. Anyway, so I just mixed together in my mind jump shots that I think would make sense, that I really enjoyed from previous years. And this is what it ends up looking like. The jump shot isn't very quick like a base 9, a base 8, or a base 11 would be, but it's most definitely not slow. It's kind of in the middle between average and fast. It's like right down the middle. Let's hop into our my court. Our my court? No, this shit is my court. You guys did not. Yesterday I was playing park with my guy Too Cool, and he's like, yo, Chris Smoove is in the park. I'm like, wait, what? Chris Smoove is in the park? And we literally, for like 20 minutes, were trying to find out where Chris Smoove was, and then he just came out the barbershop like this. And he went into the practice arena. He hasn't played a park game since. I thought it'd be really dope to play against him. Where the fuck is my mic court? I can't be the only one getting lost in this neighborhood. I don't know where things are. The VIP logo is all fun and games until you have all the tryhards in the park following you. I got 90 overalls following me, bro. Trying to drop me off, man. Leave me alone. Hey, well, drop a like on the video if you guys missed the old doorman. None of you guys should be liking the video. Guy was ass. We can skip this guy at least, right? Sheesh! Woo! Watch me miss on my own jump shot video. It's wild. So obviously, if I'm creating a high latency jump shot and I'm playing in my mid court, it's not gonna hit. And interestingly enough with this jump shot, the higher the latency, the easier it is to green. It is so weird. So I was playing, I was streaming, so that added latency. There was a massive crowd and the servers were bugging that day. All three of those things went off. Bro, the latency was sky high. I felt like I was fucking sprinting through molasses and this jump shot was greening everything. So I was like, man, I might be in a situation where I prefer higher latency right now. It does make it harder to play defense, but Jesus, was that fun. Let me get some hop action right here. Cash. I can't even see my shooter. Camera's in the way. All right, so let's talk about the details of the jump shot. The jump shot itself is amazing from limitless range, ladies and gentlemen. I have silver limitless range on this sharpshooting playmaker, and I feel 1000% confident when I'm shooting from ranges like this. And usually see like sharpshooters shooting from here, right? But if there's a screen here and I do a momentum behind the back and I do a, whoops, did the wrong step back. Let's say I'm over here, I'm looking to set a screen, switch hands. Boom, boom, boom. That's usually how I get open. It's the fastest way to get to my spot shooting. I do my neat little step back. I can shoot from here, especially when pick and roll maestro lights up and money lights out. In NBA 2K19, unlike 18 and 17, there's not nearly as much leaning shots. So you guys remember in previous years, if you moved to the side and you pulled up for a jump shot, a lot of the time they had you leaning like this, shooting a horrible percentage shot that took longer to get rid of. This year's game, you barely have to deal with that. And so if you're dribbling for whatever reason, and let's say I do this move right here in a hop, you can immediately go up and not have to worry about leaning. And so that's not even a factor anymore. If you're a shooter, that's a plus. Sheesh! One of the benefits with base 49 is that he gets high off the ground, so when it comes to contesting your jump shot, you stand a better chance of getting it off if the guy's coming out with a late closeout. And because in NBA 2K19, a lot of people opted to go with smaller wingspans because they wanted to improve their shooting, you can get away with hitting some contested shots, especially when a couple of your badges light up. It's game over. And this is with the play shooter, right? So can you imagine the distance I'd be hitting if I had a pure sharpshooter? Some of you guys are gonna ask, Agent, what do you think? Is this jump shot gonna work for big men? In my honest opinion, I've never had a big man and used base 49. Last year I used base 49, but I used it with my 6'10 slasher. I've never had a player 7 foot or 7'3, so I can't even tell you whether it's gonna work, but you can try it out and find out. If you're a player under 6'10", this jump shot's gonna work. And I say that because it does make a difference. For example, high school one, I think, is a decent base for big men, but it's a horrible base for guards. There's some bases that just make more sense the taller you are. I also made a shot maker like last night, and then I found out 2K dropped a patch, but they might've just nerfed shot creators. So I'm holding an L. I'll just go ahead and hold that. Literally in the my court this year, you cannot customize your dribble moves or your jump shots. So the one place you're supposed to practice, they make it harder to do it because you literally have to leave your my court to change stuff and then come back in to test it out. Like, man, who thought of that, bro? Whose opinion was that? Okay, so that's my favorite jump shot in NBA 2K19, and I wouldn't classify it A1 just yet. Honestly, I wanna test this out with my pure sharpshooter before I call it A1, because in every other 2K, I test with my sharpshooter. This year, I'm doing it with a play shooter. And it's hitting consistently with this build, so I can only imagine, but I don't wanna just assume. All right, anyway, let me show you guys some other jump shots in case you're not feeling this one. So I tested out base 11 with Kyrie as release one and the release two. It was my prime release last year. Haven't played prime yet on the park. I'd say it's an average release. LaMarcus with Kyrie as release one and the release two. Again, average on the park. We'll see, I'll test it in pro-am. All right, so this jump shot's a little interesting and I don't know if I'd recommend this one. My guy Benny Wonder gave me this jump shot right here. It's on normal speed. It's a slow jump shot, but it greens. The only thing is, if you're playing in a competitive game, there's no way they'd let you get the shot off before they close you out. But if you're playing in more casual games, this jump shot is money. This jump shot was a popular one in NBA 2K18. I tried it out this year. It works fantastic in low latency. In high latency, it does not work well. Again, I'm telling you guys, the reason I don't bring up jump shots like this is that I know what the best jump shot on low latency is, and I've told you guys what it is. So why would you go off and use a jump shot that's a lower tier, right? It's still a good jump shot, but there's one that beats it. So I've tested dozens of jump shots already. People tweet me their favorite jump shots all the time and DM me, try this, try this, try that. And I've tried it all. And I'm telling you, this one is my favorite so far. Again, you could try out Kevin Durant, Klay Thompson, those are straight. In previous years, 2K slowed down the best shooters. So like Stephen Curry, they gave him one of the slowest releases in the game. Ray Allen, they gave him some of the slowest releases in the game. In NBA 2K19, they sped up all of those releases. So while Stephen Curry and Ray Allen were at the very low tier last year, they almost climbed their way up to like tier 3. So in NBA 2K17 and 18, 2K would slow down shooters like Stephen Curry and Ray Allen to make it fair because they have such fantastic ratings. If they had a fast release, they'd be dominant. In NBA 2K19, they said, fuck all that. This year, Stephen Curry has a much faster release. I heard Ray Allen was a very good release and I haven't experimented with him just yet. So all those very slow jump shots you never mess with in previous years, it might pay to just try him out, experiment, and see if they rock. Ray Allen's a very easy one to point out because it's so rigid and raggedy. I don't know, honestly, I can't imagine myself using that jump shot, but I've seen point guards use it on the park. It's the easiest one to pick out. It looks so distinctive. Anyway, I'm gonna be in the lab just trying a million things out. In the process, I told my guys at NBA 2K Lab to test out Jump Shot 49 and Kevin Durant to see what they come back with, how big the green window is, how it compares to other releases. So when I get that information, I'll let you guys know. A lot of things are changing. A patch dropped today and I was hearing word that you need 87 ball control instead of 86 ball control to speed boost. But Mike Wang was saying, no, that's not true. But then people on Twitter are saying, yo, it is true. And we don't really know what to believe. We haven't had any patch notes dropped just yet at the time I'm recording this video. There's a little bit of confusion and I'm hoping it gets cleared up soon because this 2K of all 2Ks is the most confusing one. Everybody has questions and nobody truly understands anything. It's gonna be a while before we understand all there is to know about builds and jump shots and dribbling. And throughout the whole process, people are gonna be coming out with insane dribble moves and knock down jump shots from crazy ranges because so much has changed. Especially if you're a pure stretch big or a pure sharpshooter and you got that pure perfect green window. Anyway, I'm gonna leave it on that note, ladies and gentlemen. I hope this helped you guys out. For the low latency guys and the high latency guys, if you enjoyed, drop a like, subscribe to the channel. Click on one of these two videos here if you haven't watched them already. I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one. Actually, you know what? Follow my Facebook streams. I'm streaming every single day, 2K on there, bro. So if you don't come through, I'm gonna fight you. I'm out, y'all. Peace.